Hi, welcome to Chad Silversmithing. Today I thought maybe we could do a little pendant that's a simple one to make, but produces a really nice looking piece that sells pretty well. It's got a little silver ball at the top, and then it's got a free swinging twisted piece of wire at the bottom, and it looks pretty nice. It's easy to make, and so I thought I'd show you how to do that today. If you do find this one useful and fun, I'd love it if you'd hit the like button on the video. And if you want to see more stuff like this, hit the subscribe button and come back and visit some of my other videos. So let's get started. For this one, we're going to start off, it's going to have kind of a silver ball as the main focus with a piece of twisted square wire that's been hammered at either end to make it kind of flare out a little bit. And then we'll mount a jump ring on top of the end of the square wire here, and a jump ring, or two jump rings actually, onto the silver ball, and we'll hook this to the silver ball and we'll add a bail to it, and it comes out looking pretty nice. So we'll get started by making a big silver ball here. So I have some scrap here that are cutoffs from making rings and stuff like that. So making balls, if you didn't watch the ball video, which you can see up there, is sort of fun and super easy. I use a charcoal block when I melt the silver on it because it tends to create a nicer bottom for some reason. That's a pretty good size. Well, it looks like it turned out pretty good. I think I'll be able to use that one. Probably gonna spend a little time flattening this out on the bottom. When you're making balls, if you pick them up while they're still red with your tweezers, sometimes it'll pinch them a little bit, so I always wait until they turn black before I pick them up off of the charcoal block, just to keep myself from making balls that are squished looking. Nobody wants their balls to look squished. Should have a little bit flatter bottom now. So I'm going to spend a little time flattening it out even more. That's good enough for now. We can clean it up more with the Dremel. Alright, so I've got some little 18 gauge wire that I've twisted. This particular one, if I remember right, I just wrapped around the handle one of these little needle files. And that makes a good size ring for a lot of stuff. And so I'm just going to snip myself a couple of these off of here. So this is going to be the center part of the pendant. So I'm going to solder a jump ring just at the top here, like this, and then one on the bottom, 180 degrees from it. But the split on the jump ring on the bottom one, I'm going to put to the side. That'll make it easier to attach the thing that's going to be dangling from there. But we still want to solder here and here, so that'll be our first step. One of the problems people have when they first start out doing this kind of stuff is when you're soldering something that doesn't have very much mass to it, like these little rings, versus this silver ball, which is a big hunk of silver. It takes a lot longer for the silver ball to reach the soldering temperature than it does the little rings, which in this case is 1450 degrees because I'm using hard silver solder. So in order for them to reach that at about the same time, I need to heat mostly the ball first while avoiding the rings, because the rings being in close proximity will reach temperature relatively quickly. And then I can just kind of focus right there once I think they're close. But see, I jumped the gun a little bit. There it goes. So if you stick it in too soon, it jumps onto the ring because the ring reaches temperature pretty easily. But the ball itself still had a little tiny bit to go. So let's get this, I don't think that's very straight. Hey, come back here. That looks pretty good. Okay, this is a piece of 12 gauge square wire. Relatively thick square wire. So I'm just going to straighten it out first. I'm going to file the ends flat. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use my little chasing hammer. I'm going to flatten this end, I'm going to flatten this end, and then we'll give the whole thing a little twist to give it some character. But I'm going to do that off camera so you don't have to listen to me pounding. So okay, so let's flare it out a little bit here. Smooth it out with the file. All right, I got it kind of evened out and a little more symmetrical. I think now what I'll do is I'll cut another one of those little rings if I still have any of those. Okay, since this is going to attach to one side of this and it's got a curved end, I'm going to snip a little piece out of this jump ring I did so that it's kind of got an open arc out of it. And then we'll just solder it together just kind of like that. This is another one of those situations where there's a huge mass disparity between this big long piece of silver and that little tiny ring on the top. So I'm going to be focusing most of my heat down here. It takes much longer to heat that up. Grab it. Do different pairs of pliers. And twist it whichever direction you want it to go. That'll probably shine up nice. Okay. If you remember, we left one of these rings split on the side, like this, so you can open it up. That's so I can put this guy on here. And then solder in place. So the trick is, you don't want to accidentally solder anything else. So you want to try to make sure nothing, the solder is touching where you're going to be heating. We'll see how good I am tonight. Sometimes I'm better than others. got it there. Might need a little bit of filing on that solder joint. Alright, so now we have that free swinging piece, which is kind of nice. And I was going to put one of these standard kind of veils on, but I think I'm going to do something different. Normally I have these ones with a border on them because I think they look nice, but there's another variation you can do that doesn't have a border. And since I usually do the other kind, I'll do this kind this time, just for something different. So I'm going to use a little bit thicker piece of sheet. This looks like it's probably about 20 or 22 gauge. It's been rolled through the mill a couple of times to make it thinner. So it's pretty hard right now, so I'm going to anneal it first before we cut it. If you don't know, annealing is where you heat the metal up to the point where the structure of the atoms inside of it disalign themselves so they're random again. After you've been pounding on or working something back and forth, it causes those atoms to line up inside and become stiffer and springier. What this does is take that springiness back out. Let it cool just a bit and then I'll quench it the rest of the way. So for this one, I usually start with a rectangle. We'll flatten it out. I usually do this kind. Gonna try and find the center here. It's reasonably close, right about there. Center on this side. Let's there. And we're gonna have them meet pretty much in the middle of these sides, so. I'm not sure if you can see what I'm doing, but I'm basically scribing out a diamond shape out of this. It goes there, 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 there. And that's where I'll cut it. End up with something that looks kind of like that. And then I'll just take a little time and smooth out the edges nice. Okay. Or something else round to bend this around. Now this is a little stiffer than other stuff I've been doing, so what I'm basically doing is I'm laying it down. See where I'm at the edge of the table here. I'm just laying it down like this, using leverage to bend it around. If you need to, you can use a pair of pliers to do this. Like, but eventually, your trying to get it into this shape like this. Which is kind of a teardrop shape. This particular one doesn't have the border like I usually do, but it's a thicker piece of sheet, so it should be pretty sturdy. Trick on these ones is getting these ends to touch nice. And I just have to see if I can pick solder that without soldering it to itself. We'll see. Still moving. Okay, so that's pretty much all I have to do for this one. And then I'll let that pickle for a bit, and then I'll polish it up and show you the result. Polishing, my final result. So you get nice movement in the light when it's hanging. So I think it makes an attractive kind of formal pendant to wear with a nice outfit. All right. Okay, thanks for watching. If you found this video useful or enjoyable, would you mind hitting the like button? And also, if you want to see more stuff like this, I have upwards of 40 videos on my channel now with lots of techniques and tutorials. So please subscribe to the channel and get all sorts of good free content. Thanks for watching again, and happy silversmithing.